Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Now, in today's video, getting in link with another videos that I have shared earlier, I am going to elaborate the conditions and one more gland and include it into this video. And that gland is adrenal gland. Now, we all know about adrenal gland, that it is a gland that is situated on the kidney. But if we are like briefing a bit anatomy and physiology of this gland, then up to the fourth month inside the mother's womb, this gland is larger than the size of kidney. But after the fourth week, it will reduce in size and then the kidney will become larger than this gland itself. Now the right gland is like triangular in shape and the left gland is concentric in shape. So here we can like differentiate in when we are seeing those two glands, then we can differentiate about them by seeing them, the size and the shape of their organs. Okay. Now, there are cortex which is having three layers present. The first layer is zona glomerularis. Now, this layer is secreting the mineralocorticoids and the main mineralocorticoid is aldosterone, which is ultimately balancing the sodium and potassium, and it is transporting the sodium and potassium throughout the body, and it is also balancing the salt and water inside the body. So all in all, we can get the function of aldosterone, that is a mineralocorticoids, which is secreted by zona glomerulosa. Now the second layer is zona fasciculata. Now, zona fasciculata is like secreting the glucocorticoids, or we can say the cortisols, which are helping in curbing the inflammation, that is increasing our immunity system, and also it is helping the cells to direct them to use the fat and sugar, where to use the fat and sugar. So these two functions are the main functions of this layer. Now the third layer is zona reticularis. This layer is specifically used, like it is secreting the sex hormones and as androgens, and it is helping in the growth and other functions of the reproductive system. Now this is all about the anatomical and physiological aspect of adrenal gland. Now when we are moving forward, let us study one diagnostic condition of adrenal gland, that is Cushing's syndrome. I think everybody has heard about Cushing's syndrome. It is very common in women and in third and fourth decade, and it is just the increased glucocorticoid level inside the body. So we all already read this thing, that zona fasciculata is secreting the glucocorticoids, and the main function of glucocorticoid is to regulate the salt and water balance and also sodium and potassium transportation inside the body. So all the signs and symptoms and all the causes related with this this main symptom. Now talking about the causes, if there is any kind of tumor or adenoma present in the adrenal gland, which is suppressing the cortex, then it will definitely results in excessive or decrease in the formation or the secretion of hormones. So one of the main causes is presence of any kind of adenoma. The second main cause is excessive or iatrogenic administration of more and more corticosteroids inside the body. So these two are, there are other causes of this disease also, but these two causes are the main causes for producing Cushing's syndrome. Now let us understand the pathology of Cushing's syndrome. We know normal adrenal cortex. When this on the normal adrenal cortex, we are having two causes. One is if there is any excessive use of corticosteroids. Second, if there is any adenoma present, which will ultimately result in adrenal hyperplasia, that is the increased number of cells. Then there is hypoplastic changes present inside the cortex, which will result in thickening of the walls and widening of the main cortex. So this is all about the pathology of Cushing's syndrome. Now let us move on the clinical features of Cushing's syndrome. Few of the symptoms are very common and we can grab it very nicely. That is, number one is buffalo hump, that is a hump present in the upper back region. Second one is centripetal obesity. It is also very common. Then third one is moon face. And the fourth main one is lemon on toothpick appearance. Now this lemon on toothpick appearance is nothing, but if we are holding a lemon and we are just like inserting two toothpicks in it, then all the toothpick is like thin and the lemon is thick. So the appearance of that person which is having Cushing syndrome is similar to this condition, like centripetal obesity and the limbs are very thin. So these are the symptoms. Now again, in addition with all these symptoms, there are another symptoms, that is the increased level of blood pressure, because we all know that glucocorticoids are having like a function of sodium and potassium balancing and transportation into the body. So ultimately it is resulting in increased blood pressure. Now again, depression and psychological symptoms are also very important, because sodium plays a very important role when it comes to neurological symptoms. Again, if we are talking about other symptoms, which include patient can be diabetic if there is no like kind of balancing this for long time. Then other symptoms include weakness, lethargy, fatigue, mental exhaustion and etc. Now these are the clinical features. Now we can diagnose this condition by diagnosing the efficiency of adrenal glands and like aldosterone levels in the urines and in plasma levels. Now talking about the homeopathic therapeutics, there are few medicines which have been frequently used in this condition depending upon the whole symptom of the patient. Now the number one, the medicine is Quercus Ruber. Now this medicine is basically used in this condition when there is like mental symptoms are more prominent, like depression, mental exhaustion, so this medicine can be used in that condition. If there is any kind of obesity, that is central obesity, which is a main keynote symptom of this disease, this medicine can be used very effectively. Another medicine that we can use is adrenalinum. This medicine can be used if there is excessive ACTH production inside the body, and this might be the reason of Cushing syndrome. And other symptoms may be like correlating with the disease itself. Another remedy is arsenic alb. When there is thirst, excessive thirst present along with all the symptoms. These are the few of the keynote symptoms that can be present in the patient, so that we can like correlate the medicine and give that medicine to the patient. Another medicine is Hipar Sulf Calcarea. So all in all, there are many medicines which are used in Cushing syndrome, but these are the few common medicines that are prescribed in Cushing syndrome. But again, yet without consultation of any homeopath, you cannot take these medications by your own. You have to give your whole case to the consulting homeopath, and then you can like take these medicines for the relief of your symptoms and cure the disease. That's all for today. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.